This is AFTV VIP, the official web app with members only content, has no ads and a live in-game match center. The bias predictor, it has daily polls and the AFTV 11 selector. Just one click away. Hi and welcome along to AFTV Transfer Daily, the show that keeps you up to date with players that we link with the January transfer move to Arsenal. Welcome along. Hope you guys are having a great Sunday. I'm having a great Sunday because Arsenal played on a Saturday. Number one, I love when we play on a Saturday. And when you win on a Saturday and you win in the way that we've won, it makes the rest of the weekend so much nicer. So much nicer. And it was a great performance by Arsenal yesterday. I know people are going to say it's only West Brom, Robbie, steady on, which is true. But West Brom, they got a draw against Man City. They got a draw against Liverpool. They know how to dig in. And I thought Arsenal's football yesterday was absolutely brilliant and well-deserved. And that man there, Kieran Tierney, he was absolutely brilliant yesterday. That first goal by him got me off my seat. It really did. It was fantastic. We were all sort of laughing and bantering before the game about his attire. The fact that, you know, he wasn't wearing no gloves. He wasn't wearing any skins underneath or anything. Short sleeve shirt, you know, up for the fight. And he was absolutely brilliant yesterday. So was a whole host of other players. I mean, Pablo Mari there was excellent. Sobias played really well. It was a great game by Lacazette. Two goals in the game. Really, really good performance by him. Saka. Come on, what more do you say? How much is he worth? How much is Saka worth now? Every single game, this guy turns up. And he was brilliant again yesterday. And in that role, playing out there on that right-hand side, I mean, how does Pepe or Willian get back into the team the way he's playing? He was absolutely magnificent. And a big shout goes out to Emil Smith-Rowe. And he got praise from the highest corner yesterday, from Mesut Ozil. You can see Mesut Ozil's tweet there. He said, "Nice game, my boys. Great spirit. Three wins in a row. Team looks good with a number 10 like Emil Smith Rowe, the difference maker." You can never tell with Mesut Ozil's tweets are so mischievous because number 10, the difference maker, he's a number 10, of course. He's been sidelined, can't get into the team. But Emil Smith Rowe was absolutely fantastic yesterday. Really was a great, great performance by him. And not the first one. This is not just like he just turned up and just all of a sudden he's been putting in, you know, it's like a one-off performance. Since he's come into the team, he has been excellent. I've got to ask the question, do we need a number 10? In January, I was asking it to a couple of the guys yesterday after the game when I was doing the interviews. Do we need a number 10 in January? Have we got our number 10 right there? And if by bringing in a number 10, does that stunt the growth of somebody like Emil Smith Rowe, who has hit the ground running and is only going to get better? I mean, remember, he was emerging at Arsenal before he got injured. And he's, to me at that time, I've always said this, I always thought that he was the best of out of those crop of youngsters. He looked really, really good. Got the injury. Went on loan to Huddersfield last season. Was absolutely brilliant. That's really toughened him up as well. And he's just slotted straight in. And in that number 10 position, which has been a real problem position for us, he is looking really, really good. So do we need a number 10? We still need a number 10. Because you can never have just one. He could get injured. Anything could happen. We still need a number 10. Another number 10 that we're looking at that we've been heavily linked to also had a great game yesterday. And that was Emi Buendia scoring the winning goal for Norwich in their 1-0 victory over Barnsley, which keeps them at the top of the championship. He's a very, very important player. It was a great goal as well. I don't know if you saw it. If you haven't, try and see that goal today. Fantastic finish by Buendia, and that goal got Norwich the victory. He's obviously an extremely important part of the team. Still only 24, remember. Arsenal said to be scouting him really, really hard. No doubt they would have had somebody at the game yesterday taking a look at him, and they would have been very, very impressed with his match-winning performance. Daniel Farker, the Norwich manager, of course, was asked about him after the game and asked about all the links linking him to a move to Arsenal. And these were his quotes. He said, "Emi is a key player for us, an important member of the group, and he's totally committed to us. He's our player and will continue to be our player. He's on a long-term contract with the club, so we keep him. Everyone knows his qualities, and I don't expect interest just because he scored a wonder goal today. He has scored a number like this for us, and people know what he can do. It was an excellent finish, and that's what Emi can do. He instinctively knows when to make a run and then has the quality to finish like that." So if you're listening to Daniel Farquhar there, he's saying that, we are not going to be letting him go. But we all know in the transfer market, money talks, right? Now, first of all, the talk was he'd be available for around about £15 million. I noted the other day that Chris Sutton, TV pundit on football and also an ex-Norwich player, started laughing when he heard 15 million. He goes, "There's no way they sell him for that. You know, getting back up to the Premier League is valued more than 15 million. So why would they let him go for that?" There's been talk of 25 million. Any deal to get Buendia done to Arsenal is going to cost a lot of money. As I said, Norwich are top of the Championship right now. Think about it. Why would you sell your best player? You know, you don't want to sell a player like that because the rewards of coming up to the Premier League are so much. Buendia in January is going to be a very, very difficult deal to get done. It's going to be interesting to see what the Arsenal board do. Are they going to move all out to try and bring him in? Or will they say to themselves, "No, it's too difficult to do right now. Let's wait until the summer." Going to be interesting to see how that one pans out. Another player that Arsenal are interested in was playing yesterday. I did a bit of scouting on him myself, right? And that was Ryan Christie. I was watching the Tottenham game. As soon as they went about 2-0 up, I was like, "Boop, boop." Turned over the TV, watching the Old Firm derby, Celtic versus Rangers. Rangers running out winners, of course. Celtic were playing really well. Christie was doing all right, actually, until they went down to 10 men. And then it was all Rangers after that, and Rangers ended up winning the game by 1-0. But Christie, you know, without being spectacular in the game, he looked decent. He's another player being linked with Arsenal. He's been linked with Leicester. He's been linked with a whole host of clubs. Now, listen, if he's anything like Kieran Tierney-type caliber, you know he'll be a top player. And he is highly, highly rated up there in Scotland, one of the integral members as well of that Scotland team that's made it through to the Euros for the end of the season. But will Arsenal make a move for Ryan Christie? Is he one of their top targets? Still only 25, so a good age. Would fit in well at Arsenal because Kieran Tierney's there, of course, and Tierney would be able to show him the ropes. But could Arsenal make a move for him? As I said, they would have been taking a close eye on him yesterday. Now, a player that Arsenal getting very heavily linked to today is Carlos Soler of Valencia. Again, fairly young player. He's 24 now, 24-year-old midfielder. He's been having a really good season in a real struggling team. And that struggling team is Valencia, currently 17th. It's unbelievable, 17th in La Liga. I remember when I was, you know, went over to Valencia a couple of years ago and Arsenal played them. You know, they were playing good football. It's a real footballing city, Valencia. They love their team. They're a big club in Spain, but they're in all kinds of financial trouble. They've been selling all their best players now for the last couple of years. And the next one seemingly in line to go could be Soler. He scored 5 goals and has had 4 assists in 12 La Liga games this season. And Arteta is said to be a big admirer of his and very interested. Again, he plays in that number 10 position, attacking midfielder, creator, and Arsenal would be very interested in him. He's a real fan's favourite at Valencia, but they, as I said, they've been selling off all their crown jewels there at Valencia, and he could be the next in line to go. Could Arsenal make a move for him? Money would definitely, in this case, talk. As I said, Valencia in big financial trouble, but then they're also in big relegation trouble. I think they're like third or fourth from bottom in La Liga. Real danger this season of them going down, which would be disastrous for them. So would they keep Soler, or would a big bid from Arsenal be enough to get that done? Again, going to be very interesting to see how that works out this January transfer window. There are targets out there. There are, you know, potentials out there that could come in. And that position does seem to be the main cause of concern, even with Emile Smith Rowe playing really, really well. Having another player in there can do that job as well would be brilliant for Arsenal. I remember at the moment, with that win yesterday, 6 points off the sort of top end of the table. That's not a lot when you consider how poorly we've been playing. If we can keep the run going and, you know, have a good second part of the season, European places, including top four, is still up for grabs, as crazy as that sounds. So a big signing could make all the difference, and getting into the Champions League changes everything for a team like Arsenal, as we know. Julian Brandt is still being linked with Arsenal. We've spoken about Brandt already a few times on the show. And Arsenal have been linked with him ever since the, from even before the transfer window opened. Dortmund sporting director Michael Zorc was asked about the links linking Julian Brandt with a move to Arsenal. And his words were, these are his quotes. He says, "No one has contacted us. There is nothing on the table, not even in the fax machine. That's all I can say." Now, he didn't kind of point blank come out and say, listen, absolutely no way are we selling Julian Brandt. So that's the first of all, the quite interesting thing about that. He's just saying that, you know, at the moment, there's no offers on the table. He knows of nobody who's made any sort of moves to try and bring Julian Brandt in. But could that happen? Could Brandt be a player that actually could be, you know, could be of interest to Arsenal? Could Arsenal move for? It's going to be really, really interesting to see what Arsenal do in this transfer window. Let's get into some of your comments. Loads of them coming in. Football Genius says, Robbie, Arsenal should sign David Alaba, since he's a free agent and wants a Premier League move. He's a very versatile player as well. That would be a great signing. Unfortunately, I just feel that our position at the moment in the league rules us out of a signing like that. He's an Arsenal fan. He's gone on record before of saying, how many players are Arsenal fans? But he's gone on record before and said, I'm an Arsenal fan. But there's big clubs like Real Madrid and Liverpool and all these clubs chasing him, where he's going to want to play Champions League football and that. And I really don't think Arsenal got any chance of signing him. Liam says, let's get Neto, Robbie. Again, unrealistic at this moment in time. We're just not going to be able to get a player like that away from Wolves. Wolves in a similar position to us, below us now, I think. They're not going to sell Neto, and that's huge money. Flavors says, Isco over Brandt. Now, you would have heard DT, me and DT having an argument yesterday over Isco. He's dead against Isco, as a lot of fans were backing him as well. I still think Isco, for me, would be a decent signing on loan. But would love to know what you guys think. Rihanna says, Robbie, big up, big fan of AFTV. Just want to know, is Zaha to Arsenal real? Again, can't see that happening in January. I think that boat sailed. Would have been brilliant. You know, would have been a brilliant signing, I think, a couple of years ago. But now it's probably too late to get, you know, we've bought in Pepe, etc. So, you know. excuse me. Ian says Sole 11 GA in 13 games. Buendia, 14 in 19 games, each good, but Buendia, because of his Premier League experience. Lion says, sell Aubameyang and buy Quincy Promise. Some of the stick that I saw Aubameyang getting yesterday, I thought, is people serious? Nah, he's off form. But come on, right? I mean, I just feel sometimes there are some players that they've got some credit in the bank because of what they've done. So even when they're not on form, just think back and think to what they have been doing in the past and just give them a bit of slack and say, you know what, this guy's not on any form at the moment. I can understand it when you've got a player that's like, he never, you know, turns up for one game, plays well, then you don't do nothing for like 5-6 games. But this guy's been carrying us over the past few seasons. He was trying his heart out yesterday. He nearly scored a couple of goals, just couldn't get it in the back of the net. He'll be back. No, would be my one to that. Vishal says we should get Buendia over Soler or Brandt. He's everything we need. Real seems to be a lot of fans of Buendia right now. Lacazette has to be one of the most disrespected players in the league and has the 5 best goals per minute statistic in the league. Again, how many people were writing him off a few weeks ago? And he's turned it around. Abbe says, Bissouma is a necessity so Partey can play box to box. Now, I really like Bissouma. I just don't feel there's any way in which, I mean, you have to think of these things from some of these clubs' point of view. So you take a club like Brighton. They got a draw yesterday. They're struggling. They're struggling at the bottom of the league, you know, towards the bottom of the league. Are they going to sell one of their best players, right, when they still got a chance of staying in the Premier League? If anything, they can maybe consider that at the end of the season when they know what position they're in. They can get some money in to help them buy in other players to maybe then fight again in the next season. But to sell a player like that now, I just can't see Brighton doing that. Got a super chat here from Joel Morris. He says Declan Rice would be perfect for Arsenal. Maybe Arsenal should go after him. He would be perfect, but there's no way. Again, let's be realistic right now. There's no way on this earth, unless the money was utterly ridiculous, that West Ham are going to sell Declan Rice. West Ham are having a good season as well. Jermaine says Diego Costa is a good option on the bench. He's a Giroud-type player who can header the crosses we do. Again, I don't think, you know, on a loan move, I've said that before, I wouldn't be against that. But again, I know a lot of fans are not too up for that. Mexican says Isco in. He's got the experience and has played at the highest level. Jehovani, he says Emi Buendia, Bissouma, and Tarek Lamptey is all we need. Okay. Mustafa Ahmed here with a super chat. He says, I just lost it here. I'm trying to get it. I don't know what's going on today. I'm not getting my super chat's up on the screen. I'm trying to find it. But anyway, let's read what he says. He says, he said, Norwich fan. He's a Norwich fan. He says, love AFTV. It makes no sense for us to sell Buendia unless for £150 million. That's how much it costs for promotions. Wait till the summer at £30 million. And that's kind of what I'm saying. It's a difficult deal to get done right now. If Norwich was struggling mid-table, maybe at this moment in time, very, very difficult. You know what I mean? You've got to look at it from Norwich's point of view. What sense would it make to sell your best player right now unless the money's ridiculous and you can get a replacement in? Emulp says Sabitzer would be a good shout. Again, he would be. Good player. Very good player. Hey, Robbie, I think we should wait for a quality like Awar or Sabitzer in the summer. Isco on loan seems sound for me. It's kind of what I'm saying. You know, I feel that as well. Carpi says, why is everyone giving Aubameyang stick? Think back to what he's done over the past few seasons. Look at Lacazette. Look how many people were giving him stick like they are giving Abba now. Laka is now scoring goals. Exactly. Yeah? We can be too, you know, I mean, Jay Jones says, football is so reactionary. No way can we sell Aubameyang. He needs one goal and he will be start firing again. Neil says, good morning. I like to see Mari and Gabby for a few games. Loan Ainsley Maitland-Niles, buy Buendia, Christie, as a backup keeper. Lone Ainsley Maitland-Niles. I mean, to me, again, you know, Bellerin came off yesterday. Maitland-Niles come on, done well. You want a good squad. I wouldn't loan him. Joe says, would you rather Smith Rowe or Mount? Mount is a good player. Listen, Mount has been doing it for longer. But I'm happy with Smith Rowe, man. I like this kid. Liz Strigzy says, Christie from Celtic. Yes, as I said at the start of the show, a lot of interest in him at the moment from Arsenal. Some more super chats here. Marquinhos Silva says, what about Odegaard on loan? Barely plays for Madrid and is better than Isco. Otherwise, Brandt or Soler, much love from Brazil. Big up, Marquinhos. You know what? Odegaard is a very good player. I remember talking to Kevin Campbell, who covers a lot of Spanish football, and he was really bigging up Odegaard. Mart S says, sell Xhaka and Guendouzi and buy Tielemans. He knows the Premier League and he's very creative and he's very active on the pitch. No way Leicester going to sell Tielemans right now. Gunner Down Under with a super chat. He says, we've got to stop with the reputation-based signing calls. High expectations of players is a talent killer at the moment. We need low-key workhorse like Wijnaldum, who's a free agent this season, and keep Smith Rowe. My brethren Jordan's been going on about why are we not moving for Wijnaldum. Would be an excellent sign. He would. But is Wijnaldum not too similar to a Thomas Partey, where he's sort of a box-to-box type player? That's the thing. I don't know. Vichamaru, go. I hope I've pronounced that right. Apologies if I haven't. He says, focus on getting rid of players more than getting players. Will Christian Eriksen work? We work hard to get Aubameyang to sign. Why would we sell him? Listen, no way would we sell him. Deepak says, hope Eriksen lands at Arsenal. He will bring much needed creativity. Would you guys take Christian Eriksen? You know? N3D says that West Brom keeper should be a target for Arsenal in the summer if they get relegated. He's been brilliant this season. Like yesterday, he made some good saves yesterday. It could have been way more. Sagnik says Sander Berg from Sheffield. I like that Sander Berg, you know. I tell you, I've seen him play a few times and I'm like, I like the way he carries the ball. Not enough end product, but, you know, a good player. Kartik says, Robbie, any idea when Guendouzi will be back from loan? He's doing pretty well in the Bundesliga. Would you take him back? If he came back with the right attitude, why not? Especially if he's had a successful loan time. The thing is about it is that I think his loan move is until the end of the season. So he won't be coming back in January. Remember, he's on loan. Also, Torreira's on loan. There's been talk of Torreira coming back. He's not even really been getting a game. UG says, for those saying sell Aubameyang, that trainer's pass. We should have sold him in the summer. Transfer window while he had more value than today. Stick by Aubameyang, man. He's going to be all right. Richard K says, swap Willian for Saint-Maximin or Adama Traore and bring in Cantwell, Buendia and Fekir instead of Aouar. I like Saint-Maximin. I like Traore. I think both of those are explosive players. There's no way I think Willian would have that any of those two swap deals. I don't know. I could see Willian at a Wolves. Getting into some more. So many comments coming in. Andrew says, Robbie, I think you should sign Lamptey, Basuma, Brandt, and Morata on loan. You're not going to get Morata. He's having a good season. You know, again, January is a time when you have to be realistic. Yeah, you can make out these big, long lists of players and you can go and especially, you know, you look at players that are playing really well and let's get him. You know, who's going to sell your best player? If Real Madrid came in right now and they said to Arsenal, oh, you know what, Kieran Tierney, we'd like to take him, it's 70 million. Do you think Arsenal would sell him? I don't. Or maybe 70 million, I'm going over the top. But if they came in with a realistic offer, let's say they came in and they said, right, £40 million, we want Tierney. Arsenal not going to sell him. He's too important right now in this Arsenal team. He's a guy, I think he's played every game this season. He's such an important player. We're not going to sell him. He's having a great season. It's a bit the same with other teams. Brighton are not going to sell Basuma right now, you know, unless they've got a death wish with their fans. GTS says, hey, Don Robbie, lots of love from Sydney. Hopefully people will now put respect on KT's name. Trust me, man. I've done a few of these sort of starting 11s. I remember I did the other day with the Chelsea guys. Lewis was not having it when I was saying that, you know, Kieran Tierney should be in there as a left back. He was not having it, but his quality and that goal yesterday was absolutely outstanding. I want to see more of that from him. Again, it's a guy that's coming to Arsenal last season, had so many injuries, but now he's fit. You're seeing the best of him. Morgan says, if you could have signed one player this January and two in the summer, who would you sign? I still would take, well, I don't know, sign? If I could sign a player, I'd want to get a creative midfielder, but it's such a difficult thing to get. I probably would still take an Isco on loan. I would take an Isco on loan till the end of the end of this season. If he does well, then maybe think about keeping him. If not, then, you know, you go for your Buendias or you go for your, you know, some of those targets then. I think I like that Lamptey maybe in the summer. I like Basuma as well. And maybe another striker in the summer, like a different type of striker, you know, to what we have. Sarfax says Isco would be perfect for Arsenal at the moment. Ben says January isn't the best for transfers, especially with low funds. We cannot buy those players unless we offload the deadwood, where there's a lot of deadwood to be offloaded. And the problem is, if they don't want to go nowhere, which a lot of them don't want to go nowhere, or they want to go places for the same wages, it's very, very difficult to get them. Twiggy SZN says, get Moussa Dembele from Lyon, Sabitzer, Bissouma and Lamptey, Guendouzi back, and get Balogun and Saliba in the starting team or on the bench at least. I like Moussa Dembele at Lyon. Again, I think he'd be, that'd be a good signing. I think he'd do brilliantly. I'm surprised that other teams haven't really gone in hard for him, because I think his style of play would really suit the Premier League. Sabitzer, again, is another one. I think that's more a summer signing again, because, you know, Anthony says, Robbie, stop. Sporting sold Bruno Fernandes during the January title run for 140 million. Is it 140 million? Buendia talk is nonsense. They would sell for 20 to 30 and buy two replacements. No, I think it's different here. It's different here. Bruno Fernandes had been linked for quite a long time and Sporting hadn't sold him. And then eventually that January, they sold him. But he'd been linked with moves away about three different transfer windows, right? They've been taking their time. They've been getting backup players in to replace him, right? This is different. Norwich could come up. You heard what that Norwich fan says. It's worth £150 million to Norwich if they come up. And they're going to sell their best player? Rahil says, hi, Robbie. Greetings from Luxembourg. I think Eddie and Willock should be sent out on loan. Eddie's not really figured recently. Quite interesting. I reckon he'll play in the FA Cup this weekend, though. Asabas says, hi, Robbie. What do you think of Alphonse Areola, second-choice goalkeeper? And by the way, why Matt Macey's not given a chance? I reckon he will be good. Areola's decent. I'm not sure if he'd want to play coming as a backup, but then, you're coming into Arsenal. Then versus Now Football says, Odegaard could be Arsenal's Bruno Fernandes, because he did the same at Real Sociedad, and he could help Arsenal qualify for the top four. I like Odegaard, and I think, you know, he's an excellent talent, and he's wasting himself, I feel, at Real Madrid, because he just can't get in the team. But he's quality, absolute quality. Aaron says, Robbie, do you know, apart from the Chelsea rejects, our last Premier proven player for the first team was Welbeck. Who was before? That is our problem. Ryan says, do you think Brandt would be a good signing, or would you prefer to keep playing the youth? I'm all for quality in the squad. That's what we need. We you know, the more quality we can get into the team, the better. Smith Rowe's done brilliantly, and you know, I want to, you know, I don't want to like reduce his chances. However, you're playing for a club like Arsenal. You always have to remember that, you know, it is always competition for your place, no matter who you are. Amir says, Robbie, realistically, Fraser Forster, Lamptey and Buendia should be our priorities. This is an important window that could define our season. Listen, a couple of good signings, you're right. You know, it's difficult, as we know, to bring players in. LMC630 says, great result yesterday. Emil Smith-Rowe has to hold his place in the starting 11. We've been lacking creativity. It's needed. It was a fantastic performance by him. Josip says, Odegaard is considered as the heir to Modric. Real would never sell him. But if he's getting a bit frustrated and he's not really getting any game time and stuff like that, maybe we could prize him away. I don't know. Excuse me. Philip Frank says, do you think Carlos Soler would be a good signing? And from what I've seen of Soler, he's a good player. He is a good player. Brian Beste says, Robbie, we can get Ramsey on loan. No, not up for that. Troy Deeney and Fekir and Butland to push us to the top four. Troy Deeney. Oh, there was one I was just trying to... Oh, I missed that one. I was trying to find that one. Tom Preston, anyway, he says, Costa on a six-month contract. Diego Costa, of course, you know, definitely available. He's out there at the moment available, so Arsenal could consider him. I note that when I've sort of raced that before, fans have not been happy at all. Andrew says Arteta needs to go on an unbeaten run for the next few games and win cup games before he gets any backing. Rat Army will come back again. Well, Rat Army, chill. Right? Listen, you've got to praise the manager right now. I know a lot of people might say, oh, well, it was sort of an accident that he's, you know, brought in these young players and he would have still kept playing Willian or whatever. It's all about learning from your mistakes. And he has brought in these young players, whether it was by design or by luck, he's realised that they're doing the business and he's stuck with them. He hasn't just dropped Smith Rowe out of the team or anything like that, or, you know, he's stuck with them. He's, yesterday, think of it, right? On that right-hand side, he had Willian and Pepe, and both of them had to sit it out on the bench because he played Saka there. So he's making big decisions. And in the last three games, those big decisions have paid off for him. So give him, you know, put some respect on his name for the wins. You know what I mean? You can cuss off somebody and have a go at them when we're going through a terrible period. But if we've just gone three games unbeaten and they're starting to turn it around, give the man respect. That's what I'm doing. I mean, I'm telling you, after that game against Burnley, I was seriously thinking to myself, you know what, we need a change. Maybe we need to bring a new manager in. Maybe this job's too big for him. But in the last few games, he's been quality. You know what I mean? The manager. He's been quality. He's turned it around. I'm so happy for him. And I hope that he can continue that. I hope that he can continue that because we all know, you know, it's not about just three games. You know what I mean? It's 38 games in the season, already halfway through. We've got to now go on a sustained run. And if we go on a sustained run, it's very easy to push yourself up the table. Right, I'm going to do a few more. Harry Thorne says, Ryan Christie was hopeless yesterday for Celtic. Get somebody like Fekir, David Brooks or Buendia, and also a quality centre-back like Tarkowski. I think he means at Tarkowski at Burnley. Or maybe someone like Romagnoli. Marcus says, Wenger wants to return to help Arteta if he's needed. Thoughts? And Wilshire is a free agent. I think the Wilshire thing has sailed long time. On the Wenger thing, if you look at Arsene Wenger's quotes, which was very mischievously put, you know, he never said that he's looking to come back. He was asked the question, would you come back if he was asked to come and help out? And he said, yeah, I would, but I don't think that will happen, is what he says. Nene Skill says, Awar has to be the priority, Robbie, but I would take... Oh, okay. Well, another one of these trick ones here. Loan out Shaqiri. He's creative and brilliant. Shaqiri, I don't think Liverpool... I think what I'm hearing is that Liverpool are looking to keep Shaqiri. You know, they've had a lot of injuries, so they're looking to keep Shaqiri. IZ said, Robbie, where's Saliba? Well, it does look like he's not one of the young players who's benefited from recent things, and he's gonna be moving out on loan, and it's gonna be interesting to see. I mean, where players end up is gonna be really, really interesting to see where some of these players end up. Right, let me do one more here. Donovan Miller says Bissouma is an absolute boss and a must buy. Florivin Torvan would be a bargain buy. Knocking on a bit now, Torvan. His contract's up at the end of the season. Clowns talking about Costa need to pipe down. Why? And one more Buendia loving. Andrew says, Buendia is the best option. Liverpool got hidden gems. We should follow that same model. Big names, big wages, big risk, low resale. Yeah. Listen, thanks for watching the show today. Don't forget, we'll be back tomorrow at the normal time, around about 10 o'clock. With Transfer Daily. Keep your comments coming in. I really, really do appreciate them. But listen, enjoy the rest of your weekend. It was great for us to get a win. Don't forget to check out our app, AFTV VIP. On there, you can go to AFTV Picks. There was people on there yesterday that won hundreds of pounds. They also, somebody won that iPhone 12 as well. So congratulations to them. We'll be doing the next picks before the Newcastle game next week. So make sure you look out for that. But make sure you check out the app, AFTV VIP. You've got things on there where you can predict games. You can go on there. You can select your team before the game. We have written stories on there. There's also bits of content that you don't find on YouTube, like the ice bath that I do, which is kind of my reflection on how the game has gone. So make sure you sign up to AFTV VIP. The link is in the description. Have yourself a great day, and I'll see you in the morning.
This is AFTV VIP, the official web app with members-only content, has no ads and a live in-game match center. The Bias Predictor, it has daily polls, and the AFTV 11 Selector. Just one click away.